Okay, everybody. We're back with another surprise unplanned intake. I'm not going to take too much time to do it because, from what I understand, she's very, very pregnant and she may be in labor. I don't know. I haven't seen her yet. I just took her out. So I'm going to do like a very limited intake with her and then get her in her nest, and then we can observe and see how she's doing and where she's at, and then do more of an intake later if things seem to be kind of calm. So she was trapped from a site. They think she's feral, but then they weren't quite sure because she was kind of doing some slow blinking and stuff. So it's uncertain what her background is. But I'm going to try to keep things as low stress and quiet as possible. And this literally like a half hour ago, I got a phone call asking if we could take her, and I hadn't quite finished cleaning the room and doing all the stuff, so I was like, okay, and ran down here, and so I'm a little out of breath, but I just want to get her settled quickly in case she is close to giving birth, so that she can sort of try to relax a little bit. So no name, no information yet. She's been very calm so far. I'm just gonna try to feel her belly because, she is big. I might be able to feel if contractions are happening or how active the kittens are. And it won't be quite as stressful. I do want to look in her mouth and all that stuff, but I don't think I'm going to do that now because I just want to get her comfortable and settled if she's very close to giving birth. Because we need to keep it as low stress as possible. And of course, being trapped in your first car ride and all that stuff is pretty stressful. So, you're gonna be okay, and so are your babies. Don't you worry. She looks like she's definitely tabby. It's hard to tell if she's classic tabby or stripier. She can breathe under this towel, don't worry. I guess I'm not on Facebook, so I don't have to explain that. Her belly does feel very big and very tight. I'm gonna see if she's okay with me looking at her. At her back end to see if there's any discharge, because that will also help establish some sort of timeline, which can be helpful. Hi, baby. I'm so sorry. You're so beautiful. So she's had revolution already on her way here, which is great. I can feel a little bit of crustiness, but I don't feel anything wet. Sorry, I'm sorry. It's not cool, but it will help me. And it will help me help you. Okay, that's good. there's nothing emerging, which is good. So I think the best thing at this point is just to let her relax. I'm gonna put her in the nest so that that's her safe place, and I might just look in an ear. Trying to feel, see if I can hear kitten heartbeat and see any movement, but it will be actually easier and less stressful just to observe on the camera for a little bit and just make sure that I have a kitten heartbeat right there. That was relatively easy to find. So, okay, I'm not going to do too much to you. I'm sorry. Let's see if I can look in her ears a little bit. Okay, gooey but not horrible. That helps. It just helps to know what her physical condition might be. I'm not even going to look in the other one. I'm just going to look in this one. So what else? So since she's had a revolution, oh, I do want a blood type her though. Just so that we know. So I'm going to check her blood type because that can help us assess the risk for a neonatal blood type mismatch, which can be fatal for kittens. And so we can actually rule that out, rule it out or in to some degree using this blood typing test. So I'm just gonna do that. So it just requires a little, ear prick. For like a very, very tiny drop of blood. And it will reduce if there's a kitten that's born that isn't thriving, it will at least rule out one set of actions that we would need to take. So and if I haven't cut a hole in this towel, but I think she might just let me do it this way. You've been very good, and I'm very sorry about all of this kerfuffle. Good girl. What a good girl. You're very good. Okay. sometimes when they're pregnant, they have a lot of extra blood volume. And have good output. All right, and we're seeing results already. She's looking like an A, which is what we wanted. So that means we can rule out the risk of the blood type mismatch. So basically what happens is if mom is type B blood and she has multiple baby daddies of unknown blood types, and she gives birth to a type A kitten, and that A kitten nurses during the first 24 hours, she will pass on antibodies that will destroy the red blood cells. And so if they're type B, then we have to either test each kitten as they are born. Well, that's basically the only way for us to know for sure. Which is obviously a lot more stressful, but there's an easy fix to it. You just have to separate the kittens for the first 24 hours, and then their gut develops enough that they are able to digest the antibodies and it won't affect them. So that first 24 hours is kind of critical, and then after that point they can be returned to their mom even if they have different blood types. But we don't have to worry about that with her because she's type A, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure we're gonna get an A on this one. So I think that's all I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put her in there and then I'm gonna just stick a bowl of food and some nice Fortiflora in there with her. And then we'll just all observe together. Okay, let me just look at you one more time. You're being so good, and I'm sorry this is stressful, but I'm going to take very good care of you and your babies. Okay. Let's just slide. Here. Just do that. And just hold you up here. You feel so good. Can I feel your own? In there. It's very safe. It will be very comfortable. And we'll just see how you do. I mean, pet you if you stay here. Job. Oh my goodness, it's a big pillow. Oh, there they are. Look at them moving around in there. Okay, so I'm going to go observe. I'm not sure if she'll stay in there or if she'll want to come out and explore, but I'm going to grab some food and get her set up the rest of the way, trying to be as quiet as possible. Oh, she's so beautiful. confirmed type A. So that's good. And take it out. This bird. Okay, Mama. I'm just gonna put this in for you. It's all right. It's all right. I'm gonna put it on this side. Oh, okay. You're okay. Lights down. This one. Okay, my lights are on. Okay. Thank you.